went to stay at friends' houses or really did too much outside the home. She was pretty much a homebody, or at least so everybody thought, because she was very quiet and shy. This wasn't always the case at home. Carrie, as a small child, I remember one of her most common phrases that I remember was, "You're so gullible." Most children in the family, it's pretty much a rite of passage or a tradition for the oldest children to torment the younger ones. However, in my family, it seems to be that the younger children came up with their own ways of tormenting me, since I'm the oldest. While my brother had the infamous, "I'm not touching you, I'm not touching you," which he did until I smacked him, my sister was famous for saying, "You're so gullible." Mike and I would be sitting in the living room, Carrie would come flying in and say, "Mom says we're getting pizza for dinner." Mike and I would say, "Oh yeah." Carrie said, "Nah, you're so gullible." As a teenager, Carrie was, shall we say, not a morning person. She would roll out of bed about 10 o'clock, come traipsing through the kitchen, looking quite miserable, as Dad would say, "Good morning, princess." She would growl at him and keep walking on her way. Carrie changed very much, you know, from childhood through teenage years and into adulthood, and I've had the opportunity to see her grow and change into the amazing person that she is today. As an adult, she's much more pleasant than she used to be. She's learned that we're not all as gullible as she thought. But even as an adult, she couldn't stray far from home. She had plans of attending Harding College in Arkansas, but decided not to go because she didn't want to be that far away from her friends and her family. This resulted in her attending Grove City College for a while. Then the Art Institute, where she got her degree in photography, came back home to be a part-time photographer, work full-time at USIS. But in all those years, she never strayed farther from home than Pittsburgh, until Allen. For Allen, she endured periods of separation from him while he was at boot camp and tech school after his decision to join the Air Force. And then she became a military wife and went with him to North Dakota. 17 hours from her friends, her family, her job, everything that she has ever known. This is one of the reasons that I know Allen is the one. Another reason is that I have never seen my sister this happy. I've never seen her so loved, so appreciated, and so well cared for, which is exactly what she deserves and what I have always hoped that she would find. Now, Allen, my new brother. I didn't know Allen before he started dating my sister, but for the year that they dated before she went with him to North Dakota, I got to know him pretty well. I spent enough time with him that I got to know a lot about him. I don't know Allen's favorite color, I don't know what size shoe he wears, but I know the important things. I know that Allen is a man of character, a man of integrity, of honesty, with a great sense of humor, and who loves life. And most importantly, I know for certain that he truly loves my sister and treats her very well. We have family that we are born with, and we have people in our lives that we call our family, even though we have no blood relation to them. To say that Allen is my brother-in-law means that I only consider him family because of a piece of paper stating he's married to my sister. For this reason, I don't call Allen my brother-in-law. I call him my brother. I love you both, and I wish you increasing happiness with every year. Congratulations.